Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're going to do something a little bit different. We have a real opportunity for somebody out there. We have a 16 by 24 jaw crusher module that's completed and ready to go, ready for immediate sale. We had a customer who ordered one of these, and then his design changed a little bit, and he went with a little bit different machine that we built for him. And that's fine. We were happy to accommodate the customer, but we have a 16 by 24 module that is ready to go. We've got, obviously, I can't run it for you. I can't run this unit today, but I'm going to pull some footage from the exact same model as this one and show you how this thing works, and then we can go through some of the details on it, and I've got another little thing I want to show you at the end of the video. So stay tuned for that, but first, let's see how this thing works. This is a view looking down into our hopper. This is the material we're going to crush today. It's about 12-inch to maybe 6 or 5-inch at the smallest. The hopper will vibrate, the rocks will work their way down into the jaw mouth there, be crushed down to about 1-inch minus, and then discharge out the conveyor belt into that tote. So this is the results from our 16 by 24 jaw crusher module test. It made a real nice 1-inch minus product. There's some of the larger stuff, and then you can see there's some fines in there too.
we get requests to crush lots of different things through our jaw crushers, and one of the customers wanted to crush recycled glass bottles, first to reduce the volume of them, which it does by about 3 or 4 times, but also to allow him to magnet out any steel or use an eddy current to flip out any aluminum pieces that may be in his glass bottles. So this is a really cool one to do for us, and listen to that glass crush. It just sounds really cool.
All right, well, let's go over some of the details of this thing. I'm standing in the hopper now, the feed hopper. The material gets fed down there into the jaw crusher. And this hopper is a little over 6.5 feet wide, both in length and width. So it's pretty much square. Let's see if I can get this. Here's a look down the jaws there. And those jaws are adjustable down to about 1 inch minus, up to about 4 or 5 inch minus. Here's another little look. You can see the teeth of the jaw plates overlap there. So this is set pretty tight, so it can crush down to about 1 inch minus. Here's a look at the back of the crusher. This is how you adjust the jaw gap. So this bolt and spring here goes all the way through and keeps tension on the back of the swing jaw here. So that just holds tension against the swing jaw so it's not flapping out and banging against the stationary jaw. These two rods here, as you tighten those down, they pull up a wedge here in the back. Let's see if I can get a shot of this. I don't know if I'm going to be able to see this. But there's a wedge here and a wedge here. And as those pull up, it pushes this whole jaw crusher shuttle and toggle plate, and that goes down to the bottom of the swing jaw, and it pushes that whole mechanism forward to tighten the jaws. And correspondingly, if you drop those wedges down, this whole thing moves back and opens up, so the jaw crusher opens and you get a larger crush out of it. Here's a shot of the motor plate on the crusher. It's a 40 horsepower electric motor, 60 hertz, but you can wire it 230 or 460. So that's the power for that. The vibrating motor on the vibrating hopper and the motor on the conveyor are both also three phase, but they're in the half horse to two horse range. So as you saw in the previous section of the video, the material gets fed here into the jaw crusher hopper. The hopper vibrates the material down through the jaw crusher, and then the jaw crusher drops the material onto a conveyor belt that goes in here on those little rails you see there. So those two rails come out here, support the conveyor, and the discharge conveyor hangs up, you know, kind of out here somewhere, and drops it into a pile or a tote or a bunker so you can access it. Here's the vibrating motor on the hopper. So that thing, it's a counterbalance weights on each side of those shafts there, on that shaft. So as that thing rotates around, the whole hopper vibrates like this, and the material slowly feeds down into the jaw crusher. Now, some of you guys may be thinking, man, that's an awesome crusher, but I don't have three phase, or I don't have enough power to run that unit. And this is that little kind of unique thing we have right now in the shop. This is a Caterpillar genset. It's a 50 kW genset. It's in great shape. And so this unit can go with the jaw crusher module, and it'll power the whole system. So you can put this thing in your gravel pit or at your yard or your construction site, and off this generator and the jaw crusher, you have a totally enclosed unit ready to go. So you don't need three-phase power if you take this Cat generator if you wanted to purchase the jaw crusher module. This thing's got a control panel. It's all ready to go. We've had our electrician walk through the whole thing. He wired up the panel for us. It's really good. It's been load tested. We got the muffler there. It's a nice Caterpillar generator. Let's see if I can get a shot of this nameplate here. There's the model number generator. There's the KVA. There's the kilowatt. And it can be wired either for 230 or 460 volts. So, I mean, this thing in as itself is a pretty cool piece of equipment. But when you pair that Cat generator with that jaw crusher module, you have a totally enclosed system. And we've sold modules in the past with diesel motors on them, but I really, really prefer to use generators instead. And surprisingly, the generator is actually a cheaper route to go. To find a Tier 4 or those new EPA diesel motors to run that jaw crusher, it's actually more expensive to put a diesel motor on the jaw crusher than it is to buy a three-phase generator. And the three-phase generators are so much more universal. You can run not only the jaw crusher module off these, but then you have a whole power pack that you can run other pieces of equipment on. You can do switches and switch stuff around. You can do lighting. You can do all sorts of stuff. So the generator is the much preferred method for power on these big three-phase piece of equipment that we sell. Like I said at the beginning of the video, this is going to be a real opportunity for someone. It's ready for pretty much immediate shipment, and between this and that Cat generator, you got a totally enclosed system ready to go, ready to crush your rock or your concrete or your recycling debris, whatever you got. So give us a call, shoot us an email. The info is in the bottom corner of the screen there, so you can find us. I'll also put our contact information and links in the description. So if you guys are interested, reach out and grab this thing while we got it, because it won't last very long. Most of our equipment is made to order, so we don't have stuff sitting around in inventory. And on the off chance that we do get something like this sitting around, it doesn't last very long. So if you're interested, give us a call or shoot us an email. Otherwise, oh, one more thing. We have, a lot of you guys have been asking about hats and shirts. We've got hats and shirts now on our YouTube store, so you can check that out on our channel. There's a little tab on our YouTube channel for the store. I'll put a link to that in the description as well. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.